It is vital we hit each target simultaneously. Each team will hit its targets and return to base. You have your orders.
Team 1, your assigned target is a series of supply platforms. Team 2 and Team 3 are closing on their respective targets now. Get ready.
Adams, this mission is a disaster waiting to happen. We've got to clear down these objectives as fast as possible.
Ensure you stay close to your mission objectives. You must complete each target group before moving on to the next.
First platform's done. Let's move on to the next one.
Disobey the commander's orders. But you might prefer to take an alternate route when you return to the fleet.
Understood, Control. Adams, let's finish this up. And after that, we've got a detour to make on the way home. Focused on your main objective.
it.
With all due respect, sir, this mission is screwed. Is Commander Bowman trying to get us killed?
I don't like it any more than you do, Reynolds. But Control insists we need him. And when he's involved, she's as much a risk as we are.
Why? What's between those two? What happened at Akira?
The colony's blockaded the signal site. Bowman was ordered to break the blockade. We weren't at war then, and he was under pressure to avoid UNE casualties. But Bowman wanted to completely obliterate the colonial resistance. So, he brought in Control. Control's instructions were to shatter the blockade without UNE losses. She came up with a plan, and Bowman executed it.
I proposed using a civilian habitat as cover. The UNE ships fired through it and obliterated both the blockade and the habitat. The plan met the brief perfectly. UNE losses were negligible.
But that triggered the war.
That moment changed everything.
Adams, we need to get that station ready for the bombers. Strip down the turrets so they can close on the target. And the ships are...
Thank you.
window of operations. The enemy reinforcements will arrive before they complete their objectives.
Understood, Control. This is the same card that got me into trouble last time. Team 2, we've gotta go. Good luck.
Copy that, Reynolds. We can finish up here. See you at the rendezvous.
All ships, transmitting coordinates for the final objective. Team 3, this is Team 1. What's your status?
Reynolds, we lost most of our team. Nobody mentioned that cruiser in the mission brief. Control managed to divert the frigate all to our way, but she's massively outgunned.
Copy that. Adams, the frigate's in a bad way. We need to move fast. Hit the cruiser with strafing runs. Focus on the beam turrets and heavy plasma cannons. You don't have time to take out the flak turrets, so watch yourself. Control, requesting a bomber team to take down the cruiser. We need it now. Ready for the bombers. You know the drill. Focus on the flak turrets.
Control said you needed a hand. Figured we'd return the favor.
Copy that.
Immerse have arrived.
Those are Black Fleet ships.
Confirmed. Stay clear. Do not engage. All ships retreat. Fold out immediately. For all mankind's dreams about reaching new worlds, we had always been tied to the one that created us. The signal changed all that. Sent from an uncharted part of the galaxy, it told us how to escape the confines of our world. So we followed its instructions and built vast seed ships that we sent across the galaxy to populate new worlds and search for the origin of the signal. Decades passed, and the more worlds we colonized, the more fractured we became. The new worlds wanted independence, but Earth wouldn't allow it. Then the colonists found the source of the signal, and everything changed again. They traced the transmission to the crash site of what was believed to be an escape pod. There was no evidence of a crew, just wreckage. But there was new technology there, and the colonies used it to strike a deal. Earth could study the wreckage in return for colonial independence. However, the deal turned sour. Earth scientists discovered something valuable at the site, something they wouldn't share. Afraid of what they might have found, the colonies expelled the Earth team. In response, Earth revoked their right to self-rule. War was inevitable. A war fought over those vast distances is expensive. Neither side could maintain the struggle for long. But nor could they back down. The war had to end. But we could not have predicted how far they would go to end it.